Yo, welcome back, my people, to another episode of UFC 5 Career Modes in Part 6. Let's get straight into it. Seemingly better than ever, he dropped his last fight by decision. It was a fight that certainly could have gotten the way. It did not go his way. And all year during fight week, he has said that is a thing of the past. My focus is the present. I can certainly put that decision loss behind me. I'm getting a win and ideally a finish here tonight.
Round one here, reach advantage, DC. We'll see if he can employ that patented jab. Yes, he has to maintain distance. He's a taller guy. So every time his opponent tries to enter, he's going to have to take something from the inside.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Straight punch, that is useful. Good is this action about a minute in. I think I'm gassing out just watching.
I'm exhausted trying to call all the strikes that these two men are throwing at each other. What a fun fight.
Yeah, I hate to be the punch counter.
When you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land a beautiful punch to the head.
You wonder if the offensive fighter's gonna start to get frustrated here. Most, if not all, these shots are getting blocked.
They're getting blocked because he's fighting for the best defensive fighter in the UFC.
So as advertised thus far, as these fighters continue to trade strikes.
Are you both up the frame, man?
And he caught the kick.
He gets to a spot, the kaiju. Then he starts to let the knees fly.
Nice jab there. Oh, looks as though that right eye might be starting to shut. Yes, it is. Under 3 minutes now to go on the round. Well, he's certainly keeping busy, DC, connecting with most of the punches he's thrown.
I mean, punches in bunches. He's doing a great job.
Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked.
Now some separation from his clinch position. Oh, nice kick.
Oh, and so now he lands another combination, so it's never just one shot. There's always two or three coming by.
A lot of times people throw singular strikes. Not this gentleman. This man is stringing four, five, six in a row. What a great job. Punch over the top.
Nice straight right lands. Oh, going for the takedown here. Oh, really good job by him there to raise the guard, DC, and block those shots coming his way.
He does a great job of blocking all incoming strikes. Nice leg kick. Another leg kick lands.
Point strike lands there and not going to help the swelling upstairs.
I love his accuracy. Ability to get his shot to the target right away, and you see it in the swelling that is forming on his opponent's face.
Ooh.
Might get the TKO here.
Oh, it is all over. Ian Gary with the redemption.
So what a moment in this man's career. A huge finish in front of a capacity.
A minor setback for a major comeback.
I mean, I'm just sitting here stunned.
Decision loss went 12-1. The streak was broken. But the will to be a champion is still within us.
His ability to move the show. It was next
Ian,
it was amazing,
the future,
John.
Gary, just took out I've got to say his last name. Jack Macadamia. Jack Mandela.
We go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to his conference.
All right, let's go to the next fight.
48 seconds of the very first round.
For this welterweight fight,
Ian Gary versus Jake Matthews.
Here's Bruce Buffer.
Gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, the Flash. Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round one underway here, and most of you will not soon forget that the effort turned in to the young man his last time out, a twisted victory by TKO. Now he'll try to keep the momentum going. He's got an extensive winning streak here. He's got his sights set on the top five. First order of business, taking out this fellow contender here tonight. To the body it lands. Takedown defense holds up. I mean, can you imagine having an advantage like this? What a luxury!
It's a luxury. I've never had one over the course of my entire career. But fighting guys that are taller struggle whenever they are very aware of such a massive advantage. This guy is going to try and use this tonight.
Fast pace here, and here we're going. Nice. Nicely done.
This is beautiful. He's got a single collar tie.
Oh, good head movement there. Nice flip. Also, a good job defensively by him here as he raises the guard and prevents any damage.
Shades of James Toney. Always seeing things coming at him. He's such a great defensive player.
Oh, yes, it is a lost art in mixed martial arts. Not just the jab, but the double jab.
It's a beautiful double jab. And it's throwing right from the jab, too. Nice strike lands.
Matthews is swelling now around the jaw area. We'll see if he makes some adjustments and perhaps defensively raise that guard to prevent any further damage. All right, DC, half guard position. You've done a lot of good work in this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. This position loves it, too. It is the most secure position in fighting.
Oh, yeah, you got to push the camera.
On one side, half guard the other, and then you just go to work. It's the safest position, especially for a wrestler.
Matthews' nose is bleeding now, so we'll see how he handles that adversity, but nothing ideal about it here in the middle of this fight. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issues. And now some separation.
Oh.
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Forth we go.
Oh, he's hurt.
Another strike there, DC, and no surprise, the swelling only getting worse.
It's getting worse. You know, we talked about this very early, how he needed to change something. He has to change it, and now the swelling is starting to get bad.
All right, well, he rocked him pretty good, but didn't sort of smell blood in the water, and now his opponent's back.
I mean, blood in the water, you gotta go get it. You gotta go find the finish. You cannot let him off the hook like that. Because now he's motivated to try to go and hurt you as you hurt him.
All right, seems as though his sole focus is attacking that cut. And man, it's getting bad now. A lot of blood flow.
As it should. Right, he should be focused on getting to that cut, making his opponent pay. He did work. He took the cut. Now what you do to continue on the path and make the ringside position, come in here and try to stop the fight.
Missed on the strike attempt there. His stamina has really failed him here tonight. He's got to figure out a way to preserve some energy as this fight moves forward. Uppercut there blocked by Matthews. And now some separation. All right, 45 seconds now to go on the round. Look at a pass denied by the opponent. 30 seconds now to go in the opening round. We'll see what he does here. He postures up and lands to the head. stay busy from top position. He lands another ground strike there. Oh, trying to pass here, but can't make a tumbo style.
Block! Great job blocking that pass by the woman fighter.
Second round, straight ahead.
There you work. Right, the really went down over, but not before he was that boy leaking. I ain't even bleeding at all.
Back to the stool. Cut man is in. Should be able to shut that cut and prevent it from beginning. Well, if you're the replay guy, a lot to like in that previous round. A lot of damage being inflicted.
Yeah, I mean, and look at the swelling now, John. He wasn't doing what he needed to do to move his head, and he's paying for it.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two.
Great punch.
Matthews began training Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu at 15. Actually, during the off-rules football offseason, fell in love with it, and shortly thereover crossed over to MMA. Matthews gets the takedown there. Jesus. Making all these shots count. Alright, looks like he's got a couple hooks in here, DC, and defensively, you better be careful. Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet. Oh, effective strike there from the clinch by Matthews.
Another clinch position. Watch the tricky trick that he used.
Just out of range with that right hand.
Oh, nice takedown defense.
And they separate. Stuff the takedown, no problem. Again, Brinson repeat targeting that swelling, and you gotta think this is gonna start to affect his performance now.
Yeah, it's at a point now, John, where he's gonna start to get desperate. He's gonna start to make some mistakes because this swelling is not just minor anymore.
Nice work with the knee there by Jake Matthews. Fighters separate from the clinch. All right, so now we start to see some bruising appearing on the torso and all of that courtesy of the body work of his opponent.
Just the wherewithal to go to the body and the discipline to stay with that approach. I mean, it's just tremendous. You see a fighter with a high fight IQ following a game plan, and it's working.
Under 3 minutes to go in round two. Matthews gets the single leg takedown.
Good job, great recognition of seeing what your opponent was trying to do.
Oh man, I mean, how much can one man take? He certainly doesn't look like he walked out here just a few moments ago.
He's almost unrecognizable. He's been hit so many times in the face. The swelling started early. We spoke about trying to defend. We spoke about making adjustments. He didn't, and now he finds himself here.
He's got side control here, DC. You know, he's got a lot of different submissions in his arsenal once this fight gets to the round.
Oh, switch right there.
Opening for his opponent to stand back up here. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Oh, man, that left side is getting beat up now. Look at the reds there. Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. Nice job by the fighter here to continue to block the shots coming his way. He's trying to sort of fatigue his opponent here a little bit.
He's kind of watching and seeing everything that's happening in front of him. Later, you'll see him start to throw counters after the shot.
Ooh, found a home for that knee. All right, so the head damage continues to land. And at this point, man, gotta think the ringside physician is even getting antsy to check it out.
Oh, yeah. You can tell that they want to check it out. But together a great game plan for staying on that pace, making sure that when he saw the swelling start, he continued to drive him down the path to where he is right now, where he's almost under unrecognizable.
So a much different approach for him here in the second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he
has clearly found his rhythm, found the range. We'll see if he can continue with more activity here in round two. He escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Can they separate after exiting the clinch? Whiffs on the straight right hand. 20 seconds left.
Man, is my body messed up? I got no cardio.
That's both. Both land.
10 seconds now to go on the round. Two rounds in the books.
I gotta upgrade my body, bro. Cause I got like level.
What a performance in that round.
Four and a half.
I'm not sure.
He can guard you.
Enough. Total dominance. And so here we go. 5 minutes remain in the fight. Oh, he continues to attack the block.
Yeah, that was a dumbass idea. Yeah, I gotta upgrade my body.
I mean, you gotta be kidding me with that knockout. If that is not the number one play on SportsCenter tonight, I'm not sure what would top it. One of the best.
Hello, that is my old friend.
Uppercut from hell.
Here now, Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Face ain't too bad.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee
Herb. All right, on to the next fight.
Anticipated welterweight fight.
Colby Chaos Covington versus Ian Garry. This fight could actually happen. It's crazy.
Gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the
blue. We got a cross sniffer, so I think that diva's got to be on point.
Fighting out of the red corner, Colby Chaos.
Let's see this face off. Since this fight could, oh, no face off. Okay. I don't know why he took out the face, huh?
Well, his last fight will be a tough act to follow as we get ready for round one here. Brutal knockout his last time out, and that positioned him for this opportunity here tonight. So, can he keep the momentum going as the challenges get stiffer, keep the winning streak intact, and of course try to get another win by knockout to take his popularity?
Yeah, are we ready?
Oh, now get
are we ready for the takedown?
All right, here we go. First round is underway. No denying the reach advantage for him tonight. We'll see if he can get that jab going.
Look for him to circle on the outside. Use that long jab to keep his distance and only engage on his
deny that.
Oh, he did a great job of rotating into an underhook.
Oh, Colby Covington, you know he can be a volume striker, but he's not a
it's an overwhelming pressure of Colby Covington. From the hands to the wrestling, he gets forward and he tries to...
Don't let me deny it, bro. I try to cancel that.
He can't stop it. Colby drags another opponent to the ground.
Oh, and he moves into half guard. The guard...
God, that's fucking me over, bro.
Way, take the far side underhook. Look for damage from the top. Come now.
Oh, he's got the ground pound going now. Man, he's it on the ground. Another strike gets through.
In the arm triangle on the other side. He's going to lock him down, try to pass all the way across the spot. Once he gets across, he will start to drop his chest to the mat and chase the finish. Yep, gotta be very careful there.
Oh, big shots from the top.
Undeniable.
Both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you gotta be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his own. Trying to guard past here, not today.
No, it ain't happening.
Oh my lord, bro.
Big
one.
Great job landing the strike.
All right, the referee not seeing enough action there. We go back to the center of the octagon now. Man, DC, his hands look good. A lot of volume, a lot of accuracy.
He's doing a great job being accurate. He's also very fast. He's got the hands. He's creating huge shots. Let's see. He's going to be the last man standing.
And a nice job at least staying upright on that. Will wow you with pace and pressure, whether he's wrestling or striking.
Yeah, I mean, it's his calling card, right? His calling card is for him to really dictate the pace, really put the pressure.
Well, that uppercut didn't land? Come on.
All past the half guard now, and he's not popping that punches, so look for a submission attempt. All right, to the mount.
Oh, he's back up again. You gotta like that. Out of range with that one.
This is crazy.
All right, so now blood is a factor. You see he has been opened up in that eye area.
Yeah, he's got hit in the eye, and now there's a cut. But nothing to worry about too much now. He's got to be very cautious as we go forward.
Covington's pass is the... your back, but that elbow is useful. Covington gets touched by another elbow. You gotta be really careful here. Nice transition there. You call that a reversal?
Yeah, you turn your defense into offense. Defensively, you switch position and you go right on the offensive. That's exactly what he did.
And he is back up to his feet. 30 seconds now for only opening round. All right, so that opened up a cut around his eye area.
He hasn't moved his head well. He was taking shots too clean, and now a cut is opened up.
Takedown defense holds up. Well, no surprise there as he lets his opponent stand back up. Nice counter punch there as he continues to make good use of this advantage in reach. Huge shot there just before.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, second round underway. He gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds.
Oh, nice uppercut there.
Yet another. I deny that. That's fucking insane.
The Oregon State American Colby Covington. He goes forward. He knows what he wants to do. He pressures you, gets you inside of the octagon, and throws you to the floor. And it's rinse and repeat when you're in there with chaos.
Position on the ground, and now he's got the dominant position.
Yeah, what a great job recognizing that once he got the reversal.
Oh, big left hook there.
He's hurt bad.
No denying that he rocked him, but couldn't quite get the finish.
He hurt him real bad. He couldn't find the shot that would put him to sleep. He threw a lot of punches, but he couldn't get the one to land on the butt that would end the night.
Champ, look at that redness underneath his elbow. A lot of those strikes to the body start to pile up.
And being smart enough to not be headhunting the entire time. I like this. I like this approach.
Takedown defense is there.
Now they separate.
Covington gets tagged by that straight punch. Nice land for the offense there. Oh, this could be a factor. That left eye starting to close up. Oh, we told you off the top that he had a reach advantage. He really is using it. Nice punch there. Defensively responsible. Nice block. Stuffs the takedown. No problem. Hey, big knee!
Oh,
control.
Watch him pass to the opposite side. It looks real tight. He'll drop his weight and try to finish his technique.
Oh, he got out.
This guy is so aware. He never leaves anything long to allow for himself to get subbed.
Holding on to him here, not really doing too much. Perhaps just looking to recover. Well, you can feel that breeze off to the side after the swing and a miss by Covington. Takedown defense holds up. Well, this fight's been pretty crazy thus far. Both guys rolling out a lot of damage, and neither seems too bothered by it, but clearly both parties are hurt.
Both guys are hurt. Both guys are fighting beautifully. They're showing a lot of hope right now in this fight. They're both doing amazing jobs. Let's see who gets the job done at the end of this thing.
All right, trying to pass here. As Glover might say, not today.
Not today. Great job of following with the hips, keeping those legs locked and keeping the control going.
And there it is again. I think that's swelling. Why would you not, right? You doled out all the damage. Might as well go right back to it.
He's still trying to go out on the shield. He's so stubborn in trying to prove that he's tough. It's really costing him right now.
Huge block there. Nice. Nicely done. Oh, and now the under.
He's got the under. He's got the far side post. If you're the opponent, you have got to get out of here.
Level landed on both sides in that exchange. Oh, nice job by the longer, taller fighter to land a flush knee to the head. Well, he just missed out another strike there. He has not been efficient with his attack here tonight. And offensively, I think his approach leaving a lot to be desired. Gotta figure out a way to conserve some energy here moving forward. Well, we may have the best cut in the business, but I'm not sure they're going to be able to do much with that cut. It continues to widen with every passing strike.
And you're fighting a great fighter. It's hard to deal with the damage of the cut while dealing with the level of the fighter in front of you. Right now, you've got to do something different to try and change the way that this fight is playing out.
All right, so there's the end of the round. Big story in this one now, the cut. Nose from that strike, the cut man is in there. All right, so there's the end of the round. The big moment.
I already knew what Cole Cummings is about.
You ready to fight? Ready.
This is a crazy fight.
Oh, he blocked that shot and lands the hook off the counter. Head off the center line, slips the punch. That shot blocked by Covington. Looks like he's trying to set up a takedown. There's the attempt. Well, we wondered earlier why there weren't as many body strikes. He's making up for lost time here. Shot to the body connects, and that bear's watching. That's going to hurt this opponent.
I don't know why they throwing head kicks, so that's what you want to do right now.
His takedown defense.
Hey, poor Afghan.
Now be careful playing around for too long here on the ground.
Oh, he got this one.
And it looks as though he'll let his opponent stand up here. Yes, he will.
Yep, sat him on his ass.
Gotten longer in the fight.
3 minutes to go in round three.
Yeah, every fight has been a war, bro.
So the swelling at this point appears to be critical. UFC President Dana White to our left looks concerned.
Caught him. Bad business management. Bad business management. I just knew it. I found that range, boy. That business management. Ian Gary. Precision beats power. Timing beats speed.
The official decision is in
here. Yeah, we should definitely get a title shot. Cause that was the, I think Kobe was ring number two. Alright, let's go see the rankings, man. It should be a title fight, man. Bro, I beat Kobe Covington, bro. And I didn't get number three. Man, I need to at least get number one. Nah, I need number one contender, bro. Hey, give me that number one contender, man. Alright. See if we're gonna upgrade, because I'll show y'all our progress so far. So cardio. Alright, see you on next fight.
For this welterweight fight. Alright, now for the introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Number two rank, man. Alright, we gotta win this so we can take out the champ.
Well, it's good to see this man back inside the octagon. Round one is underway here. As many of you know, he won his last fight by blistering knockout. His popularity has absolutely soared since. So with momentum tonight, he'll try to keep the winning streak and the knockout streak still intact. Rachmanov going for the leg kick. He misses.
All separation to clinch.
Ooh, Shotgun Rachmanov gets lit up by that straight punch.
Nice job blocking that punch.
Attempts the front kick there.
Real sneaky body kick.
Jab. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Now some separation. Oh, left hook to the head is blocked. Just over 3 minutes to go now.
That hook was bad.
Get the turn. Oh, man. Lucky he spin.
Huge knee lands.
Checks by Rachmaninoff. Whiffs on that offering. Just over 2 minutes, round one.
Oh, man.
Man, he is so sound defensively. Nice job to raise the guard there.
It's the relaxation that allows him to see things coming and block most of the strikes that are coming at him.
Oh, looked like he might have been in range, but misses with the kick. Man, this is crazy, DC. These fighters are not trying to just touch each other. They're trying to put each other out with the shot.
Jonathan, every shot, these guys are trying to end the fight. What a start.
Oh, there's that patented leg kick. Back to the jab now, no good.
Tries to take out the leg. Beautiful leg kick lands.
Big hook. Side kick now. Under a minute now to go on the round. Once again, looking for that highlight reel KO with that front kick. Oh! Massive kick to the head. All right, so some definite damage underneath the elbow now on the side of his opponent. A lot of strikes to the body starting at him.
Yeah, a lot of strikes to the body and mixing up the attack. Not being one-dimensional, not headhunting inside the octagon. I think he has fought beautifully right now, and it's starting to show.
15 seconds to go. Ooh, looking to go to the leg kick here, just out of range. Lands the kick to the body there. Horn sound.
We're going to miss a lot of shots.
All right, so there's the end of the round, and the tide has officially turned.
That beautiful uppercut, man.
We'll see which corner can adjust here moving forward.
I mean, they've got
to
be
so. We've seen him overcome into the body from a mile away. We just step back a little bit, hit him on the chin.
Second round here. Well, in that previous round, didn't look like we would get to this next round, DC, but here we are.
He had him hurt very, very badly, but he could not find that last shot to shut the lights out, to close the door. He couldn't close the door, but that's a testament to his opponent being able to recover when he got hurt real bad.
So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Right hook to the head, blocked. Side kick. Trying to go to the body, but unable to connect. Well, he might be working towards an iterative knockout here tonight as he continues to pepper that body. Look at those numbers, bottom of your screen. That has been the most significant stat in this fight. The body strikes landed for this young man, working here towards the best performance of his UFC career.
Oh, my goodness, what a kick!
Staying busy in the clinch, lands a nice punch there. Just missed with the leg kick. Man, the body work really starting to take its toll here. Obvious redness on that right side. Straight right hand, no good. Back and forth we go. Well, not much of a setup there. Misses with the left hook.
Fast jab lands there.
So we hit the 3 minute mark here in the second round.
He is ready.
All right, they separate now. We'll see who can get off in space. This corner was pretty urgent. decision after round one. A little bit lackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round.
Barely Ooh. Missed on an uppercut right here on the inside.
Oh. MMA.
We have crossed the midpoint of this one. Well, he just hasn't been efficient with his strikes here tonight. There's another swing and a miss, and at this point, if he can't preserve some stamina moving forward, this is going to end up being an awfully long night. Oh, look at the redness underneath that left elbow. He is badgering that left side of the body.
Great block there.
Oh, nice job to land the front kick there by Rachmaninoff. Now, nasty cut on his nose. Man, both fighters realizing a lot of success early. Back and forth we go. Straight punch is good.
Leg kick lands.
Oh, nice sweep.
You know what's crazy? I started thinking to myself, is he picking up on my timing? Let me just start getting overly aggressive, see what happens. And I knocked his ass out. It's small reads like that that will make you become a champion. That's crazy. Once I made that adjustment, I knocked him out. I'm like, bro, why he's timing my combination a little bit too well. Let me get overly aggressive and see what happens. And we fucking knocked his ass out. Hey, it's reads like that. I would make you a champion, man. Reads like that, bro. That's crazy. The AI started picking up on my timing, bro. So I had to be super aggressive to knock him out.
Alright,
can we get a title shot, man? We got a title shot. Yeah, we about to do one more fight. Let's see. Just beat the number two ring and we beat Colby Covington, bro. Give me the belt. So beating the second seed only got me the sixth ring, bro. Like, are you serious? Man, I need a title shot. Alright, Kamaru. First fight. Well, we're gonna stop right here, man. This wasn't a title. That should have got his title, but don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, you know, all that good stuff. And we'll see y'all next time.